first correction to be made, please. It's a kind of process.
Please, we remain cool. We have another case. Eh? So don't start making unnecessary noise.
And I read the constitutional rights of this court. You can't keep your cool and order you out. Just listen to what is on. And we do other things outside. The court should be given the dignity it deserves so that it can educate the power of this court is the right. And if people say the court has actually given that abuse, we don't need to have the court start this case.
May it please my lord. My name is Timothy. State attorney in the office of the ODPP. I appear alongside my brother Chaze Ivan, also a state attorney in the office of the Director of Public Prosecutions. We represent the appellant. For the respondent, is my brother, counsel Semakade Isaac. He is assisted by counsel Baze Kuketa Derek. And counsel Owini Gerard. They represent the respondent. My lord, the respondent is in court. The matter is coming up for judgment and we are ready to receive the same.
My lord, for the respondent, we are also ready to receive the same.
This matter is ready. The background of this appeal is that Dr. Stella and Nyanzi, again, referred to the appellant, medical expertise, and the former secretary of Kerry University, Kampala, was charged with two counts of offenses before the Honorable Chief Justice Court. He said, before by our worship, that is concerning the magistrate of one. In count the appellant, in count one, the appellant was charged with offense of cyber harassment, counter section 24.1.2a of the Competing Business Act, with 11 particular which are records, and not go read it. In count two, the appellant was charged with offense of offensive communication, counter section 25 of the Competing Business Act, up to 11. Of course, we check also. Appellant did give the motion to both judges a strike and at the end of the trial, the lower court delivered his judgment dated 1st August 2019, wherein the appellant was found guilty of the offense of cyber harassment under section 2412A of the Computer Misuse Act, which was charged against her in count 1, the charge sheet was acquitted of the offense of offensive communication under section 25 of the Computer Misuse Act. Up to 11, judge count on the charge sheet. This appeal is against the acquittal, and raised against the acquittal of Stella Nyanzi, and raised 3 grounds of support of this appeal. The grounds of the appeal are the following. A, that the London Crown Magistrate had ignored the fact when she held that the Facebook post on the issue was not completed, as therefore arrived at the wrong conclusion in the acquitted respondent. B, the London Crown Magistrate had ignored the fact when she said that the appellant did not prove that the post on the issue disturbed the peace, quiet, or privacy of the excellence of the excellence of the law, with no purpose of completing the application. C, the London Crown Magistrate had ignored when she failed to properly evaluate the evidence of record arriving at the wrong conclusion by giving the respondent thus giving the score of justice. Now, maybe I'll be careful here. This is the recommendation also. So, Mr. Semaka, I have some issues. In the hearing of the appeal, Ms. Janet Kitim and Ms. Timothy Merritt. Is that correct?
Yes, my lord.
Both state attorneys from the office of the Director of Public Prosecution appears for the appellant, while Mr. Isaac Semakado and Mr. Brian Sebastian. So, which is which?
The name is Derek Bazekuketa. Derek Bazekuketa.
Derek
Bazekuketa. But my lord, again,
it was not him,
it was Mr. Owen.
That's why I need to get it clear now.
Mr. Gerard Owen.
Okay. From the Center for Legal Aid Campaign of Women. The closed appellant made lengthy submission both written and oral, while the closed respondent adopted submissions in the criminal appeal number 79. I think that's a correct issue. Again, I've looked at the legal principles governing trials of this nature. I've talked to the trial of the criminal nature governed by established legal principles. Clarity that payment should be made. A, in all criminal matters, consideration must be had the burden of proof of criminal matter and the standard of proof. In regards to the standard of proof, this lies with prosecution, while the standard of proof for one to be found guilty of an offense that reaches the same principle that made of the error. And I also mentioned that the principle of burden of proof is higher in criminal matters and civil matters, as is grounded, as is enunciated in Article 28(3) of the Constitution. This principle I've also mentioned, the same principle in the Wilmington versus the PPP, and I've also cited what my constant states in terms of this principle. And I've gone further to mention the holding by Lord Denning in Miller vs. Minister of Pensions, and also referred to Mr. Kuku, the chair for I've also gone to deal with the issue of duty of the appellate court, as similar to what I've said earlier before in the previous case. More important now, we're going to turn to what is before me. The appellant was acquitted of the offense of offensive communication under section 25 of computer misuse, and this is the basis of this appeal. The prosecution, which is the gross appellant, appealed against the acquittal and seeks the reversal of that decision of the honorable court. Section 25 of the Computer Misuse Act, Act number 2 of 2011, in reference to offensive communication, provides quote, any person who is repeated to use electronic communication to disturb or attempts to disturb peace, quiet, or right of privacy of any person with no purpose of legitimate communication, whether or not a conversation issues commits a misdemeanor and is liable on a conviction to a fine not exceeding 24 currency points or imprisonment not exceeding 1 year or above. A reading, the close reading of the said section, so I have two elements of the person of the crime. The first one being that a person willfully and repeatedly used the attorney computation. In respect of this, counsel for the closer planner required the evidence of PW1 in the lower court proceeding and submit that in 2017 he investigated a similar matter. Where the first respondent was charged with making offensive communication and cyber harassment in criminal case number 319 of 2017. That on 26 July 2018 at 12:31 p.m., he also posted a similar article. Counsel for the panel also charged with evidence of PW1 and PW2 as stating that they followed the process. They did follow the court, the first respondent. On her Stella Nyanzi account, and that they are familiar with how it's quite a similar article. According to the counsel, there's more than one instance in the course of the conduct. And as per decided cases, it was not essential that a case was delivered. It was not essential that a case was delivered if one would have the previous conduct. Counsel files a motion to confirm by this statement that the prosecution argued that the accused person had another file. Same nature for this court, it's a misconception term repeated. And this was an error, not true, that repeatedness should be in regard to the same post. The second element, disturbance, or attempt to disturb the peace, quiet, or right, privacy, or any person, with no purpose for the legitimate communication, whether or not a conversation issues comes to the first opponent, submitted that yes. Posing the genital section of the state of public speech, the first respondent infringed on the right to privacy, quiet, and peaceful enjoyment of the observing in violation of Article 37 of the Constitution. Counsel further argued that the said post was offensive and that it was the task of the court to ensure to censure such utterances. And the third element, it was stated that the process is the person who is responsible. But from evidence of PW1, it was clear it was her who was responsible for making the post, since from this analysis, she owns a Facebook account that was activated by telephone numbers that were listed by name. In submissions to this court, counsel for the respondent submitted that they will not give me the judgment of the lower court, but that people will come through, the conviction and sentence, and the conviction sentence, and ask the court to find out that the cause apparent is wrong. The court should find that the argument of the cause apparent is wrong and systemic. This counsel, of course, responded also to the submission of the criminal appeal case number 79 of 2018, and practiced to find this, and submitted that the issue to prosecute the cause regime was unlawful since freedom of expression should not be punished. Resolution of this course of appeal. Having found the criminal appeal number 79, the prosecution failed to prove that the lower court had jurisdiction to write offense to cyber harassment of company, section 24.1.2.8, Peter Mrs. Act, and that the person communication contrary to section 25 of the company for Mrs. Act 2, 2011, and for the reason given. In criminal appeal number 79, I'm constrained to dismiss this appeal of the following members. One, that this appeal is dismissed for legal reasons in appeal number 79 of 2019. Two, the judgment of the lower court treating the respondent to set aside. Three, the conviction and sentence of the respondent on count one, the sexual harassment is also set aside. Four, the question for the support release from custody, unless being held in custody by an illegal immigrant. Five, the right to appeal as to whether the other section 192 of the Crime Indictment Act is available to the parties, whichever it is.
Sentiments at the bar regarding the remedies, the way the language for the remedies.
Please, what is still going on? Can we maintain our silence?
How the order is different. We're looking at order two, where there was an acquit. The judgment of the lower court acquitting the respondent.
It is not the same because it was never there in the first place.
Yes. So I wanted to propose, my lord, to struck out.
Okay.
The judgment, but also to accompany the strikeout order to the proceedings and the charge sheet. So that is much now much more clear, because this is a bit confusing. True, my lord, but this is very important, because as it stands, it's injurious to our client. So we are looking for more desirable language, because the consequences of nullity are quashing everything. The charge sheet, the proceedings thereon, so we request for the judgment, so that the judgment comes last. We're seeking a setting aside for strikeout order that affects everything from inception.
So what are you proposing before?
My lord, we are proposing a strikeout or set aside order that affects not only the judgment, but all proceedings and including the charge sheet.
My lord, I appreciate the concerns of my brother. However, I live also to the principle of the doctrine of functus officio. And I believe this court is more than aware about it. So we accommodate and accept the judgment as it is delivered by this court.
My lord, should you respond to what Timothy has done? Because we want to take him to school again. We shall hold our horses.
Yes,
let him yield.
So let him first complete.
And yield.
We will yield to you. In
much
time.
Like.
See, one of the things which I mentioned in 79 is that give the party time within present this case.
I apologize, my brother.
Yes. So if you now want to cut short him, then I think I will. You may keep on contravening the constitutional matter.
So, my lord, I just implore this honorable court to be alive to the principles I have raised and welcome the judgment as it is delivered by court.
So, yes, yield.
My lord, submission from the parents counsel is, of course, misconceived insofar as it is based on the misinterpretation of the factors of official rule. The court hasn't yet risen. The judgment has yet been perfected. You don't even know whether it has been signed. It has been delivered. But we are still in the matter of receiving judgment. I have neither fingered, having touched, having fingered the judgment. There is even no order extracted from it.
I hope
you're
referring to some case where somebody said
touched. Yes. So until that process is done.
Was made.
Yes. Yes. So the court is still residing. The proceedings are still ongoing. My lord.
Okay. Okay, state what you want to state.
So, apart from the misconception of the functus official rule aside, my lord, we reiterate our request for a less injurious language, phraseology, for the order regarding.
Okay, this is the order of the court. Prepare what you think is the order arising from the dismissal of this appeal. Sign together carefully and bring it to the county chamber. In terms of what
happened.
So I don't think there's any problem with that. So I still have to also put some truth in
this. My lord, at the juncture, we request for copies by order of court. As in, so that we come to you in chambers today. We want to finish it today, here and now.
Is America available?
I'm available, but as to whether we shall conclude this, I'll see, depending on the
outcome. No, you come in chambers.
Yes. That's the point. Oh, in chambers, yes, my lord, I'm available.
You still be in court. Yes, yes. Yes.
I'm available.
As an officer of court, let me do my job, Mr. Will. As an officer of court, I request members of the press, there is a press stage that has been prepared for you just outside court. Let's move slowly so that we don't. Let's go outside. Let's go outside now.
Yes.